Hey, Mount 31, I had a question coming out of section 2.3, number 21. And this is where we're told that Fiora starts riding her bike at 20 miles an hour, then she slows down to 12 miles an hour and keeps that speed. The whole trip of 70 miles takes 4.5 hours, and we're saying for what distance did she travel at 20 miles an hour? So before we get into all of the like mathy side of things, imagine that you're getting on your bike, right? You're all fresh, ready to go, and you're just like, hey, let's do this. So you're biking really fast for the first part of your trip, right? 20 miles an hour. Then you hit that wall and you're like, whew, I gotta slow down. So you slow down to 12 miles an hour, right? So part of your trip is at this faster speed and part of your trip is at this slower speed. And we just wanna figure out how long were you biking really fast and then how long were you biking on the slower side. Keep in mind, there's no shame in 12 miles an hour. That seems awesome. So as we take a look at this, let's take a look at the numbers that were given to us and really at the units that were given to us. So the first number we run into is 20 miles an hour, right? And then I get 12 miles an hour. And then I get 70 miles. And then the last number we get is 4.5 hours. So let's just start to parse out where these numbers go. So let me just change highlighter colors as we move through here. So when I see rate, well, these numbers here are rates. So I know that the 20 and the 12 will somehow go into this R column, right? Now the next column we run into is time, right? So if I look at that, I have a time number or time units here at 4.5 hours. So I know somehow the 4.5 hours will be in the time column. And then the next one we see is distance, right? So I can see that miles is a unit of distance. So I know that 70 has got something to do with that distance column. And then we just got to figure out how this relates. So, oops, let me go back to my pink highlighter. So the 20 and the 12 are the most direct. They just straight up go here and here. So she was going at the faster speed of 20 and then the slower speed of 12. Now, what they don't tell us is how long she was traveling at 20 miles an hour and how long she was traveling at 12 miles an hour. All they tell us, let me move highlighters over, all they tell us is that it took 4.5 hours. So whatever this time value and this time value are, I do know that they add up, they total out to 4.5. And in that same vein, they didn't tell us how far she traveled at each of those different speeds, but I do know that these two speeds have to total out to 70 miles an hour. And that's why you see that equation there. All right, so D1 plus D2 has to equal 70 and T1 plus T2 has to equal 4.5. And if we just start to keep track of where we are, we have four variables in this problem. I have 1, 2, 3, 4. So I want to say here so far, I have four variables. And if we look at the equations I have so far, the ones that are highlighted, I only have two equations. And I need a 1-to-1 ratio, meaning if I have four variables, let me go here. If I have four variables, I need four equations. And right now I only have two. So there's got to be two more equations hanging out. And they come from this, that rate times time is equal to distance. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go over here and I'm going to make, ooh, gosh, my iPad has not been backed up. That's fine. All right. So I'm going to make this equation that 20 times T sub 1 is equal to D1. And there it is. Right. And then I'm going to go make this equation that 12 times T sub 2 is equal to D2, and there that is. And now if we go through this, I don't have two equations. I have four equations, and that's a good thing. That means this is solvable. So let's try and make some sense out of this. So the first one I'm gonna do is start with this D equation. So I know D sub 1 plus D sub 2 is equal to 70. All right, but what I'm gonna do is instead of D sub 1, I'm gonna write 20 T sub 1. And instead of D sub 2, I'm going to write 12 T sub 2. So that's why you see 20 T sub 1 here and 12 T sub 2 here. All right, so now if we take a look, right, I've got two variables in one equation. And again, I want that to be equal or even. So I need to get this down from two variables to one variable. And I do have a way to relate T1 and T2. So let me go look at that red equation I put together. Let me change my pen color over to red, and I want to look at this one. So if T sub 1 plus T sub 2 is equal to 4.5, I can opt to solve for either of these variables, but I'm just going to solve for t sub 2, meaning I'm going to subtract t sub 1 from both sides, and I'm going to get that t sub 2 is equal to 4.5 minus t sub 1. So I am just changing up that red equation. And what I'm now going to do is I'm going to take that, and instead of writing t sub 2 here, I'm going to substitute in 4.5 minus t sub 1. And now I'm in this great position of one variable, one equation. All right, and I have that 1-to-1 ratio. That's great. So now I'm going to distribute the 12, right? I'm going to collect some like terms and then perform a bunch of algebra. And ultimately, you find out that t sub 1 is equal to 2, which is great. So you've got this time value. Now, before I go answering the question asked to me, I just want to point out, if she was traveling for 2 miles an hour at the faster speed, that means t sub 2 must be 2.5. Because again, keep in mind, she was traveling for 4.5 hours. So if she's 2 hours over here, she must have been 2.5 hours over here, because the total needed to be 4.5 hours. Okay, but let's go answer the question asked of us. This says, for what distance did she travel at 20 miles an hour? So let me erase a bunch of what I have here just so it's not too crowded. Okay, so I want to know, for what distance did she travel at the faster speed? So let me get my blue highlighter back. I want to do this equation, and really, I want that number. But keep in mind, you know now that this is not t sub 1 anymore. I mean, it is, but really, you know it's the number 2. So if I multiply these two numbers together, right, I'm going to get 20 times 2 is equal to d sub 1. So d sub 1 would equal 40, and the units on this would be miles. So that's where you see me saying that Fiora traveled 40 miles when she was going at the faster speed of 20 miles an hour. All right, thanks so much, everyone. Bye.